Good morning, everyone, and happy Monday. It is Julie here with your TipRanks pre-market morning update, giving you everything you need to know before the market opens. I am here Monday through Friday with videos out before the opening bell. So if you aren't already, make sure that you're subscribed to the channel and turn those notifications on so that you can stay up to date with all of our latest videos. Today, we'll be taking a look at stock market news, biggest gainers and losers, as well as notable earnings reports. So here we go, starting off with stock market news. U.S. stock futures are down slightly this morning, with both the Dow and S&P 500 futures down 0.15% and the NASDAQ down 0.3%. Microsoft could snap up Nuance Communications for $16 billion. Bloomberg reported that the deal could be announced today. Nuance Communications uses artificial intelligence for the healthcare industry. A Bloomberg Intelligence senior analyst reported that this can really help Microsoft accelerate the digitalization of the healthcare industry, which has lagged other sectors such as retail and banking. If Microsoft were to acquire Nuance, it would be Microsoft's second largest acquisition since it acquired LinkedIn for $26 billion. Microsoft does come in as a strong buy, with 23 analysts all giving it unanimous buy ratings. The current upside potential on average is about 10%. Chinese electric vehicle company XPeng is said to be beginning to produce their own autonomous driving chip in-house. The production started a few months ago and is taking place in both the US and China. Deutsche Bank's Edison Yu said that the industry sources indicates XPeng is actively recruiting chip engineers. He believes this suggests that there are plans to grow this effort moving forward. Looking at the wider picture, Yu believes it is all part of an effort by the industry and government to lower the dependence on foreign chips. The XPeng stock does come in with a strong buy, and the average price target of nearly $50 would be over a 43% growth potential. In biopharma news, we have Sorrento Therapeutics subsidiary Scilex, who has received approval from the US FDA for its supplemental new drug application for Xatlito. Sorrento Therapeutics owns around 99% of Scilex. Their Xatlito is a polymer-based lidocaine topical drug that will now have an FDA-approved label reflecting its usage while showering, bathing, and swimming, saying that it can be successfully reapplied and could remain on the skin for up to 12 hours. Sorrento Therapeutics does just have 4 analyst ratings, but they all come in with a buy. The average price target of $28 would be a 272% potential upside. And we also have AutoNation, who has inked a strategic partnership with American professional soccer club Inter Miami CF to become the soccer club's official and exclusive automotive partner. The partnership entitles AutoNation to naming rights of Inter Miami CF's stadium and branding of training kits. They'll also become the sponsor of the Saves campaign. The program calls for $100,000 in donations for every save that the Inter Miami goalkeeper makes, with funds being donated as part of the campaign going towards cancer research. AutoNation doesn't have any recent analyst ratings on their stock, all from at least 2 to 3 months ago, and currently comes in as a hold with an average downside potential of over 18%. Now, taking a look at this morning's biggest gainers and losers. Starting off with this morning's biggest gainer so far, and that is Wilhelmina International. Trading under the ticker WHLM, they're currently up 66% in the pre-market. We also have Pintech Technology Holdings under PT, who's up 26%, as well as Nuance Communications under NUAN. They're currently up 22%. Now, taking a look at this morning's biggest losers so far, starting off with Irithm Technologies. Under the ticker IRTC, they're currently down just shy of 26%, followed by Qualigen Therapeutics under QLGN, who's currently down 16%. And Brooklyn Immunotherapeutics under BTX, who following a gain of 25% on Friday, is now down 12% in the pre-market. Now moving on to notable earnings reports. And honestly, guys, it is pretty quiet today as far as earnings reports go. Before the opening bell, we're set to hear from Afria and in the aftermarket, Simulations Plus. But we do finally have some big companies coming up later this week that will be very worthwhile to watch. Starting on Wednesday, before the opening bell, we're expecting to hear from JPMorgan Chase, Wells Fargo, and Goldman Sachs. In the after hours, we'll be hearing from Shaw Communications. And on Thursday, we're set to hear from even more with Bank of America, City Financial, and BlackRock, plus a lot of notable others. So make sure that you tune in later this week to see how all of those earnings reports come in. So that is Monday's pre-market morning update, getting you up to speed with everything you need to know before the opening bell. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and say good morning in the comments down below. Also, don't forget to check out the TipRanks Twitter page to stay up to date with all of the latest market news. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we will see you back here next time.